Welcome back to The Witcher 3. At the end of the last episode, I was going to continue the Following the Thread quest, helping out Lambert to find Hammond at Farrow. But as I noted at the end of the last episode, for some reason, it was telling me where Farrow was a fast travel sign, which obviously doesn't make any damn sense. That's not where I needed to go. So I looked it up online. Turns out, what that means is basically you can't actually go there yet. Farrow is apparently actually located on Skellige Island, which I haven't actually gone to yet. So that's why it was telling me to go to the fast travel place, because I guess it was the quest's way of saying, you can't do that yet, advance the main story, and find a way to Skellige before you can do that. Not a very good way to communicate that. That should be a lot clearer, but regardless. So that means I could, if I wanted to do Following the Thread, what I could do is the main quest, Destination Skellige, find a boat headed to Skellige, which would obviously unlock the island once I get there, and then I could do the Following the Thread quest. But the quest that actually has me go there in the main quest is level 16, which is relatively high, and I don't want to do that yet. I still want to focus on lower level stuff and stuff around Novigrad, because I'm not anywhere near done with Novigrad, so I'm just going to do bits and bobs of quests left in Novigrad. Starting with fencing lessons.
Greetings! You here for a specific reason?
Got a meeting with Rosa, a fencing lesson.
Geralt of Rivia, yes? Miss Rosa stepped out for a walk, near Temple Bridge, she said. She asked that you join her.
Guess it's gonna be an interesting lesson. Thanks.
Oh yeah, 9 experience points. Moving up in the world.
Fresh sheep's liver. Where's one to find it these days?
Awful pile.
Interesting.
Help, save me.
What's interesting?
I'm dying of poverty.
Eternal fire. Father of all. Eomar.
Hey, there are mouse droppings in this bread.
Droppings, my eye. Those are raisins.
I'm warning you.
That's it, Roach.
I know you. You're the one killed him first.
I can't sprint with my horse here? There we go.
Stand and fight!
You again?
Him.
Some more? Bruises on your ass heal already?
On God, I say! Victory will be mine this time. I've practiced with shield and sword. Many a headless scarecrow around here. Heed my warning and stand and fight!
Don't have time to give you another lesson.
Tis I shall give thee the lesson!
Okay. Sure. Even your tower shield can't help you.
Come closer.
Wow, I'm really mistiming my blocks. Wow, damn, that did a lot of damage!
No! I yield!
Not enough?
Yes, but next time...
Go back to Mate Bilberry and apologize for being an ass. Quick, before I change my mind and break your bones.
We shall meet again!
I get the feeling I'm gonna meet him throughout the entire damn game. What a fool.
Geralt, over here!
Nilfgaardian Regiment always accompany you on your walks?
Always. Papa's orders. It's for your protection, Rosa dear. People here hate us. Why? What have I done to them? But enough about that. Soldier, you may leave.
But His Excellency Ambassador Var Atra said that...
And this Excellency is telling you otherwise. Do you not recognize him? This is Geralt of Rivia, the best swordsman the North has ever seen. I'm safe with him. Now march off, quickly. Left, right, left, right. Finally. Let's go, Geralt. I've something I wish to show you.
I know she's a schemer.
You're using me. Don't like it one bit.
And I don't like lacy frills and Redanian novels, but you don't hear me complaining. Now follow me.
She's using me as an excuse to ditch her guard. Doesn't want to be watched with whatever she's about to do.
But fairness in your eyes.
There must be order.
Here. You see, I thought that instead of training in a dank old cellar, we'd move around in the open air. A duel on a bridge, like in the novels. Now draw your sword.
Only got my steel and silver swords. We should be fighting with practice weapons.
We should, but you of all people ought to know. There's much more fun in doing things you shouldn't.
Yeah, you realize how sharp these swords are, right? Okay.
If that's what the lady wishes, just don't want to see anyone crying later.
I've a hanky for you, just in case. On guard!
I didn't even have time- oh, come on! Didn't have time to pull my sword, you cheater.
You'll never learn.
Yes. The only thing you've really hurt is my pride.
I'm pretty sure I gave her so many gashes that she'd be bleeding to death right now.
By the way, how'd you get interested in fencing?
I was bored. I've no friends here. Papa keeps me on a short lead. It's banquet after banquet after banquet. I detest banquets.
Boring conversations, terrible food, and weak booze.
Exactly. At least with a sword in hand, I can have some fun. You know, blow off steam.
All right, what's next?
We should return. Just forgive me, Geralt. I know this might sound awkward, but would you mind turning around for a moment? My corset's shifted. It's pinching me terribly.
What?
I can understand the woman wanting
no.
to look pretty.
What is she doing?
Fighting in a corset, it slows you. Rosa?
What in the
Shit.
Hell is she up
she
to?
She ran off. Anything happens to her, Var Atra will kill me. Need to find her. Can't be far.
Far from home, aren't you, sweetie? And there's no telling if you'll ever get back.
She's Ambassador Var Atra's daughter. She's got diplomatic immunity.
I don't really understand the shite you're saying. Now it's clear you love your black ones.
It's no surprise, Lucas. Witches are drawn to monsters, just the way things are. But this beastie... We'll tend to her ourselves.
I'm not giving these bastards money.
Let me rephrase. Put it in words you'll understand. Piss off.
Well, well. It's not just black ones who tell us what to do. It's witches as well. Too bad I listened to neither. Get him, Lucas!
Good luck. You fucking ready? Strangely satisfying to kill
those
people.
Understand now why your father insists soldiers follow you around?
So they can save me, as you did.
No, so you won't need saving to begin with. Rosa, those humans died because of you.
What of it? Do you expect me to shed a tear? Observe a minute of silence? They were dregs. They got what they deserved.
Lesson's over. Remember what you've learned today. Looks like you'll be using that sword often.
It's beyond me, Geralt. I don't understand you. Why concern yourself with the fate of two drunkards? The world would be a better place without...
You should go home now. And take the shortest, not the scenic route.
I understand. Farewell, Geralt. And good luck on the path.
So I guess that's the end of that quest line. Okay, let's do something else in Novigrad. Yeah, it looks like I've got three quests already for Skellige. Black Pearl, the Thread one, and then the main quest. Haunted House, level 7. Haunted houses are awesome. Sounds really fun. It's really low level, so it's probably not going to give me any useful rewards, but should be a good time at least.
Look awfully suspicious to me, tramp.
What's he doing here?
Wonderful.
Hail, Kissel.
Oh. I must render aid. What do you need, citizen?
What do you want?
Name's Muggs. Rostin Muggs. Need your help in a grave matter.
What's this grave matter?
I came here on business. Sadly, just there across the river, toward the bridge's end, I was attacked. Smashed a bottle of the finest dwarven spirit on the bugger's skull. But the robbery was still a partial success.
Tell me what you want already, and be brief.
Thief ran off with my documents. Very important document. I need you to get him back for me.
It'll cost you. I don't work for free.
That I know. Since the dawn of time, no witcher's lifted a finger without pay. I've a smattering of coin in the soles of my boots. Return the documents, and it's yours.
Fine. See what I can do.
Might be my last chance. I'm out of ideas if this don't work.
What's he doing here?
Dwarven moonshine. Nothing stinks quite like it. There's the bottle. Muggs was attacked here.
Maybe it was one of those jackasses I just killed. Gird.
Hand over the documents, thief.
Me? A thief? I won him straight, I did, in a game of cards.
Not how Mug sees it. Claims he was... mugged.
He lost, demanded them papers back, and when I refused, he walloped me over the noggin with a bottle. Barely escaped with me life.
I'll play you for them. With how bad I am at Gwent. You know what? Let's try it.
Played cards for them once. Care to play again? You're clearly in the middle of a lucky streak. Could very well continue.
You might be right. Let's play.
If their deck is even half decent, I lose. Alright, what have we got? Got all the weather cards. Any garbage cards? No, these are actually pretty good. I don't have any of the really crappy ones that do like one damage. Do I want to reroll anything? What's my unit distribution? Actually, you're not too good. You only do 2 damage. You do even less. Give me another one. Oh, Jesus. I shouldn't have rerolled it. I got a 1 damager and then a 1 damager. Alright, so yeah, unit distribution. I've only got 1 frontline soldier. Okay, so that's my weak point. Frontline soldiers. Let's try to bait more frontline soldiers out of them, and then I can use cold to nullify the effects of the frontline soldiers. Nope. Bait didn't work. I don't know if putting another frontline soldier on my frontline actually baits them into putting frontline soldiers on theirs. Don't know if that works. Let's put a crappy siege dude back here. Is it time for a weather card? Let's do it. Sure, put more on there. It's not gonna be very effective. Get a little bit of ranged going on. Get some siege. And we win. Okay, actually, that was not too hard. So I really do stand a chance here. Looks like ranged is gonna be the thing I'm best at. It's unfortunate that the one weather card I used is for the thing that I need the most now. Like, I want that weather card back. Because these two are gonna weaken my own troops. There's really not much I can do other than just play everything, I guess. Put my weakest card out first in case they use that one card that destroys my most powerful card. They didn't. Okay, I'm still in the lead. Well, I'm gonna win this one, I think, so I'm just gonna play everything. That's fine. That doesn't change anything. Do I just pass my turn? Or do I want to take down the damage of ranged? I don't want to take down the damage of ranged. Okay, I'm just gonna pass. You got 2 cards, come on, what have you got? Thanks? That's fine. I still win. Ooh. Does that mean- wait. I feel like they maybe threw the game there. I feel like they could have won, but they threw it? I'm not really sure.
I win.
I ain't blind. Take the damn things. Let none say I ain't an honest man.
Gods know, I'll only ever say kind things about you.
That cutting sarcasm. That's the first game of Gwent I've won in, like, forever. don't suppose you sell any Gwent cards, do you?
This living, Witcher.
Nah, I guess not. Yes, I don't know if Muggs was telling the truth or not, or if that guy was telling the truth or not, but regardless, looks like I'm gonna resolve the whole thing without anybody getting hurt, so, not bad.
They ought to never let your kind in, no regret.
Well?
Found the thief who took your documents.
I can't be. Let's go get him. You can hold him while I take what's mine.
Slow down. See, this man said he never attacked you. Said you lost to him at cards.
Ach, cheeky bastard. But like me Aunt Rosalie always said, lies got but wee legs and don't run far. The documents belong to my employer. A deed to a townhouse in Vingerberg. And true enough, I've been drinking. Got a bit carried away. I lost them in a game of cards.
Then you whacked the winner on the head with a bottle.
What was I to do? He weren't willing to give him back. When the scoundrel drew a weapon, I fled. But without them papers, I haven't the gumption to show me face at home.
Here, now pay up.
Of course I will. Give you all I've left. Wouldn't have it any other way.
One experience point. I feel bad for the other guy. I kind of want to give him the coin, but I guess I can't.
Hey, yeah. Come
okay,
on.
Back to the haunted house. Wait, visit the haunted house again? Yeah, I've already been here. Why do I have a quest for this?
Have one without the other.
Then I don't want them.
What's going on up there?
Witcher? Witcher? Kareen, look who's come.
Huh. Live here together now? Didn't know.
Once you told me Sarah had been responsible for my nightmares, I decided to see if the devil's as scary as they paint him. Or her. I came in to find not a fiend, but our little Sarah. And I can't say why, but we took a liking to one another immediately.
Long ago, to isolate themselves from a world of beasts, humans began building cities. But since beasts prowl within stone walls as well as they do outside them, this did not allay human fears. The truth is, walls guarantee no one's safety. The place where you lock yourself in and lock all else out, that's not your home. Your home is sometimes a place you travel long and far to find.
That was a kind of awkward cutscene. I get what he was trying to say, but I don't know, it just felt kind of strange. Next thing. What shall we do next? I thought there was like one more. Oh, this one, right? Yeah, what is this about? That's when I walked into the bathhouse, heard their conversation. Something. Let's go talk to a dude. Things will happen. And no, I refuse to put my actual armor on. These clothes are too damn fancy.
Played at Horsan's den.
What's he doing here?
A wee minute, Witcher. Now, I'm curious something mighty. How is it you were off the same bloody night Horsan tried to kill me?
'Twas chance, honest. I was at the brothel. I've witnesses.
I don't doubt you found some witnesses, but I do doubt the bit about chance. Know what? Shite conversation, this. So much blethering, we've got nowhere. Lad, you have a chat with him. It's simple. I want to know where Horsan is.
I've not betrayed you. Not ever. No! No! I know nothing!
Help me find Junior.
I'm about to send my lads around Horsan's hideouts. Once I know to a witch's blade, lead my men, take the water Junior, and drag him out of his hidey hole. Win-win situation, as I see it.
That's right, I remember now. This guy's the hothead that wanted to find him. And I was, I guess, given the choice to either go to him as I am now to get his help, or help him, work with him, or do it on my own. I don't want to work with this guy, though. I don't like him. Nah.
Not interested in your squabbles.
Figure out what you want, come and see me.
Yeah, I don't want anything to do with him. No. Let's just do this on our own. So let's just go from hideout to hideout and see if we can find him.
A million debits and a million credits.
Why? Let's see, where's the nearest one? All up there, okay. Come on, Roach.
Come on, Roach.
The blood of babes. Elven blood, eh?
Ooh. Darkness everywhere. I see it all around.
Stop scaring us, beast.
Why do you pull out your sword, Geralt? Are there bandits down here? Weird. Again?
Arms, arms and red, please, provoke.
Not like that. Draw it out.
Okay, come on, Roach. Whoa, what's going on over here? I forget it. Just go away, Roach. I can't even attack the bandits. Ooh, quest item, certificate.
Another drift.
Looks like they just murdered somebody. Let's figure out exactly why. Let it hereby be known that the bearer of this document is entitled to fight in the ring under the name of Zdenek.
Temeria.
Pretend to be Zdenek to take part in the fights. Okay.
Now you, the eighth.
Sure. For the arena, I guess?
You heard.
If there's one thing I can do, it's fight.
Don't linger.
Greetings.
Don't know you, not letting you in, and don't you fucking stand there.
Ah, so I guess by doing that, I don't have to pay the fee or do any of the other ways of getting in?
Recognize this piece of paper?
Fight contract.
Good, you can read. So who's this contract made out to?
Says, Zdenek. Made out to Zdenek.
Mm-hmm. I'm Zdenek. Any more questions?
In you go. Don't you go wandering. Straight to Igor now.
Fair enough.
I'm gonna be the fanciest damn fighter they've ever seen.
Come on, get ready. Your turn now.
I am ready. Losers get paid anything.
Losers get carted off to the cemetery.
Look at all these sweaty, disgusting men.
What grace, what style.
I've seen better.
Remember our deal,
I switch this sword for a rusty one. You need to hold on for it.
There's your coin.
That's it.
We agreed to leave this city somehow.
That's a big dog.
Milk in his belly makes a mess.
I need work.
What can you do?
Good with a sword. Wouldn't scoff at working as protection.
And who here would you protect?
Do I even want to mention Horson Jr.? Probably don't want to play my hand so early, right? Nah.
Crowds can spin out of control. Somebody's got to keep the peace.
Claim any kind of experience?
Let's not let on that I'm a monster hunter, although it's probably pretty obvious from the fact that I have two swords.
Done my share of fighting. Wouldn't carry a sword if I didn't know how to use it.
Have you killed humans?
Sometimes.
Why not come out and say you're a witcher? It's plain to see.
Not looking for any monster contracts. Need a regular job for a while.
I'll have to test you. I want to see how you manage in a fight, if you can fight at all. You shall fight in the arena, survive three bouts, and I'll put you to work.
Set me up.
Already have. Shall we start right away, or do you need time to prepare?
I'm good.
Always prepared.
Excellent. Let's see what you're worth. Remember, you fight to the death. The crowd doesn't take kindly to those who spare their foes.
Let's do this.
Ready your purses! Betting is open! From the Far East, where a man's life is worth less than a cup of water, a witcher, a murderous mutant. His opponent, Gustav Rhone, a man who cut his way out of his mother's womb with a knife. Never a fight
kids.
To the death.
You need the risks.
Three children.
Kill! Kill!
Right, not supposed to spare him.
Kill! Kill! Kill!
I don't give
kill.
A damn. I'm not gonna kill him.
Kill! Kill!
How do I spare him, by the way? Do I have to interact kill. With him and then say spare? Or if I interact, would that be killing him?
I will not kill him.
Ah, there we go.
Release the hounds!
Oh, I'm gonna have to kill dogs now? Fucking asshole.
Keep it together, legs.
There seems to be some serious problems with the weapon sounds in this game. Like half the time they just don't work.
Born brawlers in battle! A fracas,
poor dogs.
A rumpus, a fray! The Witcher versus the Hairy Brothers, straight from the Wild Isles of Skellige. Sired by a mountain bear,
yield.
They live
like
to
brother.
Kill.
Never.
The Witcher and Gustav Rowan defeat their opponents. Next fight, the Witcher doing what he does best, face to face with beasts.
Fine, bring it on. What are you? Wyvern, huh? A wyvern would be... let's see if I can get this right. A wyvern is a draconid, right? Yes. Let's get some oil on. I don't have any draconid oil. Okay. Just like completely broken. Got any more? Come on, send in the wild hunt. I'll take him on. I think my friend just maybe died. Alright, let's put on the right oil for this. This one, I do know. By heart, insectoid. There you are. Oh good, my friend's still alive. Put on some beast oil. I forgot. Are you steel weapon or silver? Steel. Is this enough bloodshed?
Bravo! Plowing Scragdom Farrah. They tell me a true bruise had come to the arena. Would you believe it? They were right.
Got Junior's attention.
Thanks.
Cyprian Wiley, known the most as Horse and Junior, appreciates good handiwork.
Well,
we've nattered enough. Now,
Cleaver's dwarves are in the sewers. They've slaughtered the guards.
Don't stand here like a sodden prick at a wedding. Muster the men and get out those midgets. And would someone please kill the blasted witcher?
Excuse me. You admire my handiwork and now you think you can kill me?
You heard the man. Kill him!
Hold on. Before you kill me, can I meditate for a second? I want to get my stuff back. Thanks. I really did just meditate, what the hell? That doesn't make any sense. Alright, come on. Oh, you know what? This is time for some bombs. Ugh, that didn't... God, only hit one person, that sucks. Okay, holy shit. Get some fancy footwork going on here. I am just a killing machine. It's both disturbing and also really satisfying. Igor's key, I just got. Poor dogs, though. Just raised from birth to attack people, and then slaughtered in the ring. I don't blame the dogs for attacking me, I blame the assholes who trained them. Hey, how's it going? Have fun with that. Oh, now I can attack. Oh, holy shit. Okay, yeah, my lack of armor is really, really causing me to take a lot of damage. Nice hit. Some of these bodies seem to be kind of like teleporting a bit. They're behaving really strangely in a couple ways. Well, apparently I know where the hideout is. I'm not actually sure how I know that, but apparently I do. Looks like I can still go to the other places. Oh wait, search the arena for information about Horson. Yeah, I didn't think I was done. We are definitely not done. Get some healing going on. Oh my god, die already, please. Here we go. That's what the key was for. Message from Igor. Says there's been some misunderstanding lately about the valuables, and a bit of blood's been spilt for no plowing reason whatsoever. I'd like to reassure you, All the coin is safe and sound in the lockbox. The blind asshole who thought it was missing was looking in the wrong place. Walk down the corridor leading from the upper level towards the arena. Turn so your back's to the grating and look to the wall opposite you. If you've eyes to see, you'll find what you're looking for. Let me emphasize that Horson Jr.'s crowns have not been touched. Not a single copper's missing. I swear on my own handsome head that they're secure and waiting to be picked up. Okay, walk down the corridor leading from the upper level towards the arena. Turn so your back's to the grating and look to the wall opposite you. Or go to the place on the map. I was thinking there'd be a way to jump down, but nope. How do I get down to the arena? Here we go.
Floor is worn by a moving door. Something behind this wall.
Here we go. That's not a lot of grounds, unfortunately. But the information's the most important part. Torsen Jr. King Radovid is unhappy with your performance. You were to rid the city of the other members of the so-called Big Four. Yet not only do they still live, but they also know of your role in their attempted assassination. That was not our arrangement. For the time being, hide in the place which the messenger delivering this missive will indicate to you, and stay out of sight. His Majesty lives in the hope that mutual animosity between the other members of the Big Four will finish the job which you attempted, yet flubbed so badly. So they were working for King Radovid. My, my, my. That's a big boss to have. A freaking king. But that doesn't actually tell me where the hideout is, does it? Only the messenger would know.
Wonder if Dijkstra knows Jenner's made a deal with the Redaniums.
Yeah, that's really, really important. I wonder why King Radovid would be interested in who the big players are in Novigrad. Okay, well, I think that's a pretty good place to end the episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm gonna find Junior.